95. Between local lines, notes from the Emirate.
Notes from the Emirate, indeed, running until the 3rd of May. So we've got two more days, today and tomorrow, to take part in what is or has been identified as a very, very rich exhibition with some rare scripts as well, taking place here in the Emirate of Sharjah. Cherry on top, it's free to attend.
Oh, yes.
And we're talking about the Tales from the East exhibition. And to talk to us more about this, we've got His Excellency Ahmed bin Rakkad Al-Ameri, the Chairman of Sharjah Book Authority. A very good morning to you, and such a pleasure to have you in the studios with us.
Good morning to you and to your listeners who can listen to us in anywhere in the world.
Exactly. And we're talking about a very global exhibition. So in your words, how would you describe the Tales from the East? Because in the opening ceremony, we saw how busy you were with His Highness, and it seemed like everyone was very motivated for this exhibition.
Actually, Tales from the East, it's a unique exhibition. It is a showcasing of collection of early written materials, including books, manuscripts, and some rare artifacts. The entire material is valued around 60 million dirhams. So 60 million dirhams worth of showcased. The exhibition is organized by Sharjah Book Authority. It opened from 8 p.m. until midnight. And the last day is until the 3rd of May. The visitor can come there, enjoy the books, enjoy drinking some coffee, and they can be very safe. It's in the, and the exhibition is inside the Sharjah Book Authority headquarters. And the unique thing about it, people from Tales from the East, they can explore a lot of the impact of the Arabic civilization or the Islamic civilization all around the world, especially from Andalusia or Spain up to China.
Yeah. Which brings us to the question, because in the break you kind of wowed us with what the rare items and manuscripts are available or exhibited at the exhibition. Can you talk to us more about what kind of rare items we will be witnessing at the exhibition?
We have a lot of wow factor inside it, if you can say that. It's not only wow, it's a very rich and considered to be the heritage of humanity and the heritage of the Islamic and the Arabic history. And they're showcased there, and some of them even for sale. There is a very unique Quran you're going to see. The impact of it, it is not only that. It you show you the impact of the Islamic religion with this holy month now. And you can see from Mughal area, you can see some Qurans are from China. And you can see one of the most expensive Qurans in the world that's written by a woman.
How much is it worth?
It is not for sale. It's only for showcase.
No, but I'm just
But it's one of the rarest one you can find. And it's written on gold leaf with pink paper inside it. So it's a very unique Quran.
The history of the calligraphy is incredibly fascinating. And you've touched on this a little bit in your answer, talking about how it's a showcase of the history of Islamic civilization and just how far it has reached. Can you talk to us some more about the significance of this exhibition, what it truly means and what it showcases?
It showcases many things. There's some books are reaching up to 350,000. There is one of the oldest printed copy of Mecca. It's valued around 150,000 euro.
Wow.
There is one of the oldest picture taken of Mecca also as a photograph from the 1888. You're going to find a lot of old picture of Sharjah and Dubai from the 1940s. You're going to find a lot of books that coming from the third century or fourth 1500. Some of them is one of the most unique books are also from 23 volume is the description of Egypt. It is one of the unique books that been done by the French when they occupied Egypt, when Napoleon Bonaparte was there.
Wow.
And it is one of the most beautiful books you're going to see. It has very beautiful artwork in it. You're going to see a lot of globes there, unique globes. You're going to see many things, especially you're going to see a lot of one of the richest collection of 1,000 night and night. You're going to see those tales and copy of those, all this copy of books in many languages from Arabic, English, French, German, Russian, Chinese, many different languages, Spanish. You're going to see all those books are displayed in that exhibitions.
And what kind of experience are you hoping visitors would have by witnessing all of these incredible works and artifacts?
I think people can, when they come there, they can learn about history. If you don't know your history, you don't know the history of the country you live in or the community you're living in. It is enrichment. It's an opening your mind and your eye. It is opening... A lot of people don't know the impact of the Arabic civilization and the Islamic religion into the world and what they, enrich the world by producing a lot of manuscripts, especially in medicine, especially in science, and even not the Islamic and even the Middle Eastern civilization and their impact, like the pharaohs, the German when they came, how they were fascinated about it. You're going to see also a lot of medicine books, astronomies, many of the things that we see now, you're going to learn about it there. And there's a lot of sessions also take place while the exhibition is taking place.
It's very interesting. So the Tales from the East exhibition is taking place, obviously, at the Sharjah Book Authority building. And it's going until tomorrow. It's today and tomorrow. It's from, I believe, from 8 until midnight.
Yep.
It's taking place in time. So if you wanted to be kind of like a tour guide for the guests, what is on the cultural agenda when you come in the building, and what to do?
I mean,
when you get there,
it's just very simple.
You just walk around.
Uh-huh. You see the showcases. You can ask the exhibitors about some information.
There are tour guides.
There is no tour guide, but if they need information, there's someone to
guides.
Help their
okay.
guests. Because it's very simple description. There's all the books have description on them.
Nice.
So people can know about it. It's in Arab and Sabaya languages, and people can learn about it. You can ask whatever you want to know. And it's a journey. It's a really good journey of humanity and the human race, what they did and the impact, regardless what gender we are coming from or what ethnic we are from. You can see it all together in one place.
And it's free to attend, right?
It is free.
And you don't need a prior appointment?
Nothing.
Okay. Perfect.
What really amazes me is now the amount of treasure they've got under one roof, and whoever's going to come in, and as you said, it's going to be cultural enrichment. But what people don't know, what goes behind the scenes, how did you bring all of this? How did you get how long did it take to put this all together?
I mean, it took a time. It was planned for last year, actually.
Okay.
It was planned for last year it was planned for Sharjah when it was the World Book Capital, but because of the pandemic, it was postponed. So started this year. It is a unique exhibition. There's a unique speakers also in it. I mean, there's a very famous speakers who are speaking about the manuscript. There was the ex-minister of Egypt of Cultural, who was one of the speakers who attended. And then there is also from Saudi Arabia, who attended and spoke about manuscript and important. And you'll be shocked about the information you listen from those people. You know, there's over 100 million of manuscripts of Islamic and Arab civilization that are, people don't know where are they. They are mixed between libraries and lost. Right. And about people how abandoned book and burned booked all around the year, around the world and around the civilization. There's a lot of those manuscripts was burned. Or sometime the author, he wanted more paper, so he deleted. He erased the manuscript, and there's a lot of manuscripts are missed in the world, and people are still looking for them. It's a unique journey in history, in the humanity life. And today we have a very beautiful sessions, by the way, going to take place today around 11 o'clock. Okay. About 10 o'clock. And this is about authentications of manuscript. The speaker are from France and from Austria. So you can see how the globalization is going, taking place in one place in Sharjah Publishing City or Sharjah Book Authority, as you can say it.
That's wow. Interesting. Probably a lot of science goes into that authentication process.
Yeah, I mean, I saw one beautiful book. It was in display, then they removed it. I said, why did you remove this book? It was a very beautiful book. I mean, it have a beautiful illustration in it. It look wow.
Amazing.
And then he told me, it's a fake book.
Ah.
It's a fake, we cannot put
oh.
fake.
So
I mean, if you see it, I mean, if any one of us see this book, he will not believe this is a fake book.
Wow.
You think it's a very ancient book.
Yeah.
At least from the 15th century or 13th century. And it's a religion book. It was have a beautiful drawing, illustration about the beginning of humanity from Adam and Eve. And I mean, they have the drawing, and it goes into different faith.
Mm.
The, you know, it's not the Islamic faith. It's also the Christianity faith and the Judaism faith. So you can see all of these are in one book's drawing, you know. And it was fake book.
Wow. Mm.
It's a real problem, yeah.
Yeah.
And then this session today is going to help people identify in terms of how to detect a fake copy or not. Well, on the Morning Majlis, we always give you some recommendations what to do. So let's give you a bit of a Sharjah experience if you're driving in from other parts of the country. Come on down to the Emirate Sharjah. Offer your Taraweeh prayers at the Sharjah Mosque. Head on over to maybe one of the cafes and restaurants in Al Jada, and then move on to Book Authorities right next door. A proper Sharjah experience for you tonight if you're planning on coming down. Thank you, Your Excellency Ahmed Rakkad Al Ameri, for joining us today and enlightening with this discussion about what to expect at the event tonight. Tales from the East. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
So that was Ahmed bin Rakkad Al Ameri, the chairman of the Sharjah Book Authority. If you'd like to catch up with this discussion, listen in, do log on to our SoundCloud and Apple podcast. That's where the podcast will be uploaded. And on our YouTube page, the video interview will be out. Stay tuned. You're listening to the Morning Majlis only on Pulse 95.
If you liked this episode of the Morning Majlis, drop a like and subscribe.
95.
Be sure to follow us on Instagram for all our daily updates and top stories.
Bubbles.